Namaste, welcome back to our channel Ayurveda 360. In this video, we are going to analyze a logical reasoning for a question. The question is, in the context of Raktakshaya, Acharya mentions regarding Amla and Shishira Preeti. Have you ever thought regarding why actually this phenomena occurs? So this video helps us to understand the same. So the reference what we are trying to identify from this video is from Ashtangardayam Sutrasthana 11th chapter, which speaks regarding Doshadatuma Lakshaya Vriddhi or Vriddhikshaya, and from Sushruta Samhita Sutrasthana 15th chapter, where he again speaks about Doshadatumala Vriddhikshaya. So in the context of Raktakshaya, both of them have some similar opinion. That is, Rakte Amla Shishira Preeti Sira Shetile Rukshata. This is from Vagbhata's version. Sushruta also says regarding the Tvak Parushita and Amla Shita Prarthana. So he uses different terminologies, otherwise the meaning is same. You can see the videos or the shloka from here. So have you ever thought regarding why this phenomena actually occurs? Practically we see these kind of experiences by the patients. Those who are having Raktakshaya, they tend to crave for those food items which are usually Amla in nature. Also, they tend to stay in such places which are usually Sheetala rather than Ushna. So this is practically observed, that is why the curiosity even increases. Of course, even the other Doshadatumala Vriddhikshaya Lakshana are also practically seen, but they are somewhat different. Rather than usual, you can say the other kinds of Lakshana, like person becoming thin, or you can say becoming fat, other kinds of Lakshana are obvious, but this is somewhat different. That is why we are analyzing this. So for understanding the reasons for this, first thing is regarding which dosha is actually involved in this case. Raktakshaya, of course, the dhatu is the pradhana dosha here. It cannot occur without the involvement of dosha. So now, which dosha is involved in a case of Raktakshaya? This is the first question. So the dosha involved here is Raktakshaya will always be associated with Pittakshaya. Why? I think you got the answer. Regarding Ashrayi Bhava, what reference we are able to see here from Ashtangradayam again. Whenever there is Raktakshaya Vruddhi, he is always associated with Pittakshaya Vruddhi because of Ashrayi Sambandha. Another thing is, Rakta being a Dhatu, here undergoing Kshayavastha, Dhatu Kshayavastha always is accompanied by Vata Vruddhi. So Vata Vruddhi is another of the Dushta Dosha here, or you can say the involvement of Dosha here. Any of the Dhatukshaya, Vata is involved. So from Pittakshaya, Raktakshaya point of view, Vata Vriddhi and Pittakshaya, these are the important phenomena, or you can say precursors for understanding the phenomena. Next thing is, whenever there is Dosha Dhatumala Vriddhi or Kshayavastha, in you can say Chaya and Prakopavastha, what happens usually is the body tends to ask for the opposite guna, viparita guna iccha. So Chayo Vriddhi Swadhamni Eva Pradvesho Vriddhi Etushu. So whatever is the cause, that will not be craved by the body, whereas the opposite guna, Yukta, Ahara and Vihara, are usually craved. And this is nothing but the defense mechanism of the body. Body itself tries to bring back the Dhatu Samyata as soon as possible by this kind of defense mechanism. Now, if you analyze Vata, Vriddhi and Pittakshaya, now the body needs to bring down Vata and to go for Pitta Vriddhi so that Dhatu Samyata is attained. So I think now you got the point. Actually, the body is under the status of Vata, Vriddhi and Pittakshaya. Now I have to bring it back to the normalcy, Dhatu Samyavastha. For that, I need to bring down Vata Dosha and I need to bring up Pitta Dosha. Now, analyze the rasa from the Ashtangardaya Sutrasthana first chapter, or you can say any of the authors. Swadvamla Lavana Tiktoshana Kashayakaha. So these are the six rasa. If you analyze the six rasa, first three rasa, Tatradya Marutam Gnanti, Madura, Amla and Lavana are responsible for Vata Shamana. This is the first point. Now I want to bring Pitta Dosha towards normalcy, Pitta Vruddhi. I need to take such kind of food which will increase the Pitta. Increase in the sense, in terms of bringing it to Dhatu Samyavastha. So which are those rasa? Here you have Amla rasa, here you have Lavana rasa, and here you also have Katu rasa. Why? Because Kashaya Tikta Madura are responsible for Pitta Shamana. Now I don't need Pitta Shamana, rather I need Pitta Vriddhi. So analyze the two sets of rasa, Swadvamla Lavana to bring down Vata Vriddhi, and then Amla, Lavana and Katu to bring the Pitta Vriddhi, to bring it to Pitta Vriddhi Avastha or to bring it to Dhatu Samyavastha. Which are the common rasa you observed there? Yes, one is Amla and another one is Lavana. Katu and the Madura doesn't suit here because it is not good for both of them. It is good for either of them, only for one of them. So Amla and Lavana are those rasa, if the person consumes, will be able to get back what he actually needs, Vata Kshamana and Pitta Vriddhi. Now Lavana rasa, how long can you take? It's a very limited kind of rasa, rather than other five rasa. It is necessary only for bringing the taste to the food. Even if a slight amount of Lavana rasa is increased, we usually don't like the food. So that is why person may not crave so much. It may not be to that extent that it may be written in a shloka. So Lavana rasa, necessary in the sense the person will feel that, but not to that extent. But Amla rasa, the person will definitely will be able to experience. So that is why Amla Preeti is mentioned here. Amla Preeti will be responsible for Vata Shamana and Pitta Vriddhi, so that Dhatu Samyavastha is brought. I think you got the point regarding why this rasa. Next, regarding the Sheeta Prarthana or Sheeta Icha. Amla Sheeta Prarthana. So now Sheeta Prarthana, why it happens? So this is explained in terms of Mahabhuta. Rakta is considered to be Panchabhautika. Of course, Sarvam Dravyam Panchabhautikam. And in the same way, Rakta is also Panchabhautika. And where it is mentioned, again, Sushruta Samhita Sutrasthana, Adhyaya number 14, where he explains regarding Visrata, Dravata, Ragaha, Spandanam, Laguta, Tata, in terms of Prithvi, Ap, Teja, Vayu, Akasha. So these are the five properties of Rakta because of the dominant Mahabhuta, because of the presence of each Mahabhuta. But if you analyze the important or predominant Mahabhuta, Vyapadeshastu Bhuyasa, probably the Dravatva, that is Jala Mahabhuta, is dominant when you compare it with the other. So in this context, the Drava Guna, or you can say the Drava property of Rakta Kshaya, is more seen. Whenever a person has Rakta Kshaya Avastha, Drava Guna Kshaya is usually seen. In the sense, it is dominantly seen. Visrata Dravata. Dravata is attributed to Jala Mahabhuta. And Jala Mahabhuta is considered to be in Kshaya Avastha dominantly. Others are also there, but dominantly this one. And because of that, the opposite property of the Jala Mahabhuta is slightly increased in the body. That is Teja Vriddhi. Whenever there is the Sheetalata is reduced, so the Teja Mahabhuta in the body really increases. Comparatively, it is a comparative term. So for that purpose, now the body will require Sheeta Prarthana to bring it back to normalcy. So now the Sheeta Prarthana is nothing but the person is trying to get back the lost Sheetata, or you can say the reduced Jala Mahabhuta due to the Raktakshaya. I think you got the point. Raktakshaya leading to Dravakshaya, which means ultimately the Drava Guna of the Rakta is reduced here, which means Jala Mahabhuta is predominantly reduced, which increases, or you can say on a comparative scale, the Teja Vriddhi is seen in the body. Whenever there is Teja Vriddhi, the body will itself like to stay in a Sheetala Pradesha. Even the Ahara can be Sheetala in nature. In the sense, Sheetala Ahara Vihara, the body will usually crave for. So now you got the point. So whenever a person is feeling, can say, excessive heat in the body, definitely he wants to stay inside an AC room, inside a room where there is fan being switched on, or he doesn't want to stay in the hot sun at least. So in that way you can analyze this. So from rasa point of view, Amlata, and from the other Sheeta and Ushna point of view, it is the Sheetata. So in this way, we are able to analyze why exactly Amla Sheeta Prarthana is seen in the context of Raktakshaya. The same has been explained by the Dalana, but in a very brief way. Dalana commentary you are able to see here. He doesn't explain in detail. He explains it in a very brief way, and I will try to expand it or elaborate it so that the steps can be easily understood, and once you understand this, you will never forget. So that is the beauty of this kind of logical reasoning. You will never forget, and you will also be able to apply it to the other aspects. So that is the advantage of analyzing these kinds of questions. Another opinion, what he says, Dalanam, and not so much you can say convincing, regarding the both Soma Tattva and Ushna Tattva being present in Rakta Dhatu. So Rakta has both Soma Tattva and Agni Tattva, and whenever there is Rakta Kshaya, so some people consider it under both Soma and Agni Tattva being reduced here. So directly he mentions regarding the Agni Tattva being reduced will be brought back by the Amla Preeti, and the Soma Guna is reduced here will be brought back by the Sheeta Prarthana. So almost the similar explanation, but a direct explanation not that much convincing, but still that can be given as an answer. So both Sheeta, I mean Soma Tattva and Agni Tattva being present in the kind of Dhatuk like Rakta leads to Amla Sheeta Prarthana. So this is also another way of explanation, because the entire universe can be classified under Soma Tattva and Agni Tattva, everything including the Virya. So from that point of view also it can be explained. So in this way we have tried to analyze why this concept of Amla and Sheeta Prarthana occurs in the body during Rakta Kshaya. I hope you like this video. For watching such kinds of videos again in future, kindly like this video, share and subscribe to our channel. Ask your other friends, Ayurveda loving friends, to kindly know about our channel and share the links with them. There are multiple playlists, whichever is necessary for you, you can go through that. And there are a few fun videos as well for specifically students, some competitions. So kindly go through them regularly so that you can be a part of our channel as well. So until next time, myself Dr. Nandish J. Thank you.